Are you doing spot reduction exercise? If you're doing that, stop it right now and I want you to watch until the end of the video because I'll explain exactly why it's doing more harm than good. Welcome back mga kwentuhan. So nandito na naman tayo sa isang episode na video na i-discuss natin today. And if this is your first time in this channel, so please make sure to hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to hit that notification bell as well, ha? If you wanted to be continuously updated on how you can become healthy and fit. Alright, so usapang spot reduction tayo. Spot reduction exercises yan. So karamihan sa mga exercise, they are following yung tinatawag na spot reduction exercises. So, though as it can be helpful, but in reality, it's doing more harm than good in terms of your goal to become more, to have that better aesthetic in terms of kagandahan ng katawan. No? For example, gusto nyong mawala yung taba sa bilbil, o yung gusto nyo magkaroon ng flat stomach and abs. So usually, anong gagawing exercises? Puro ab crunches, all lahat ng klase ng ab exercises gagawin na, no? Though as we think that it can be helpful in terms of totally doing better physique, dahil sa spot reduction exercise na ginagawa nyo to burn down the fats, eh technically hindi naman siya talaga nakakatulong, no? Dahil you're wasting your energy on something that's really not helpful and beneficial. Dahil kahit 100,000 crunches gawin mo dyan para ma-improve or mabawasan yung bilbil mo sa katawan or sa chan. Hoy. So yun nga, no? So kahit 1,000 repetition ng crunches or kahit anong ab exercise ang gawin mo, pero kung hindi mo babaguhin yung diet mo or lifestyle mo sa pagkakain, hindi yan siya makakatulong, no? So instead of doing that several multiple repetitions for you to take down that belly fat, do this instead. So I will give you natural way on how you can reduce the fat in your belly without even doing a lot of ab crunches exercises. I will share with you 6 steps or alternatives. Let's just do it that way. I'll give you 6 alternatives that you can do instead of doing a lot of those crunches exercises for your abdominals. Okay? Number 1, you start with calorie deficit. Okay? So in my previous videos, I have discussed about caloric deficit and how it's very important in reducing fat percentage in your body, especially dito sa may belly area. So caloric deficit is very important. Second, avoid too much carbohydrates. 3, eat more proteins and high fiber foods. Number 4, you may want to start your diet with food that is high in monounsaturated fats. Okay? So, ano ba yung mga example ng mga monounsaturated fats na foods? So, in my previous video, I'll put it in the description box below. I talk about different types of fats when I was talking about keto diet, no? So I'll put the description box below or click on this video above, and I recommend that you want to watch that as well because I explain in details on ano to mga klase ng fats na to. So for the purpose of this video, monounsaturated fat example nito would be yung mga olive oils, avocados, ano pa ba, nuts and seeds. Yan, so mga example ng monounsaturated fats. So you may want to consider as well that you really want to add this fatty acids because it reduces the risk of you becoming obese. You may want to consider also doing cardiovascular exercises. Okay, so you may want to consider as well as practicing weight resistance training. In my previous video, I discussed about what is the benefit of weight resistance training, so you may want to watch that video also. Okay? The last step or technique or recommendation that I want you to do to have that flat belly or flat stomach is next is, ito medyo unorthodox to, is you may want to drink more, if not a lot of water, no? Because if you drink more water, then your body will start to flush all the fluids because alam niya na laging merong consistent na water na pumapasok sa katawan. So instead na i-store niya yung tubig na yan, ilalabas niya na lang siya kasi alam niya consistent yan siya. Not only it's helpful, it also brings down the water in your belly area. Okay? So mga kakwentuhan, I want you to please take note of this. And there has been a lot of studies made in the United States regarding abdominal fats, no? That says that it's really very harmful. It's a very harmful kind of fat that is in the body that is linked to you having heart-related diseases and having diabetes and you being prone to becoming obese also, no? So please take note of that. That's why it's very important that you really take care of your health and consider the steps that I said above and how you will be able to flatten your stomach, okay? So just two additional bonus that you can put into consideration into your diet is number one, avoid eating refined sugar. And second is you may want to track your food intake, no? So yan yan siya. So sana makatulong sa inyo itong mga steps that you can use as an alternative instead of you doing spot reduction exercises. So yun mga kakwentuhan, so sana makatulong ito sa inyo. And if it did, please make sure to hit that like button. Yan, paklik nyo yung like button. And share it to your friend and family also. Okay? So kita-kita ulit tayo mga kakwentuhan next week. Okay? Bye-bye!